I wanted to talk today about how you should watch what you watch and be really mindful about the content that you're consuming. The media has proven time and time again that they're not here to help you. They're here to make money. They're here to drive clicks, get you emotional, make you mad, make you upset. It's the same thing with Twitter and Facebook and Instagram. The tweets and posts that get the most likes and the most engagement and the most retweets are the controversial ones. Not the nice, wholesome ones, but the ones that make people angry. Obviously, 2020 has been crazy, but does that mean it should negatively affect your life and how you feel personally? Obviously, there are outstanding circumstances for some people. People have lost jobs. It's crazy. I mean, it's objectively nuts. But you can still control a few things. You can control your attitude, you can control what content you consume, and you can control the way that you think. A lot of people will disagree with me on the last one because most people are controlled by the media and the media outlets that they see. Not in a negative, like, the media's out to get you. It's just, if you watch certain content, you're gonna lean a certain way because that's just what you believe. I'm not a super political guy, but what I've tried to do during this time is to watch the content that I'm watching. I noticed this just a few weeks ago. I was watching a lot of negative content. I was watching what I would call sort of brain dead content. And that's nothing against the content creators. I actually really liked a lot of them. I still consume some of the content. I just don't consume it on a mass scale like I used to. I was watching a lot of Pokemon videos because it's kind of interesting to me, but I was watching those constantly. I was watching a lot of Warzone videos. That Call of Duty game. I was watching a lot of video games and mind-numbing content videos, and I noticed while I was watching them that I wasn't thinking. I was just sitting there going, huh, this is nice, this is fun. Oh my goodness, shoot that guy, or oh my goodness, he won that battle. Whatever it may have been, I noticed that I wasn't thinking the way I used to. The content creators that I like to watch, the Peter McKinnons, the Machiavellas, the Jordan Petersons, these people that are all different, but they make you think in a different way. Peter McKinnon's a camera guy. He makes you think about the way you're framing your shot, the way you're lighting your shot, the way you're audioing your shot, the way you're editing your shot. Machiavella's a minimalist who's trying to get people to think more minimalistic. Jordan Peterson is just an intellectual. The guy is just straight up and really, really smart. Whether you agree with him or disagree with him, I think we can all agree that he's really, really hyper intellectual. These are people that make me think. When I'm watching their videos, I'm paying attention to the videos and I'm consuming the content, but I'm also like over here thinking about, oh my gosh, I could throw away this thing, or I could donate this thing, or I don't need this thing, I could get rid of it, or maybe I should buy this thing and get rid of these four things, and that way I can minimize a little bit better when I'm watching Matt. When I'm watching Peter McKinnon, I'm doing the same thing, but with cameras. Jordan Peterson, same thing. I'm watching and I'm learning and I'm thinking about, oh, he thinks this, but I actually disagree with him on this, so on and so forth. So I noticed that I was catching myself watching some mind-numbing content. And I think it's really easy to do. We live in the notification era. The thing we use the most is also the thing that causes most people the most amount of stress. Everybody is allowed to post content all the time. That's a positive, but it can also be an immeasurable negative.
Based on her data and the results from other studies, Dr. Baggett is among scientists who believe screen time stimulates the release of the brain chemical dopamine, which has a pivotal role in cravings and desire.
So you're more likely to act impulsively and use social media compulsively instead of like checking yourself.
But I found myself not doing them. And I found myself spending my free time doing stuff that I didn't really like doing, whether it was just watching something or playing a game on my phone or playing too many video games. I was okay at the time, I wasn't upset, but I knew that I wasn't like actively being fulfilled and I wasn't striving towards anything. And I genuinely believe that motivation can come from yourself. That's where it probably comes from most of the time. But watching other people do things that you want to do is a great motivator as well. For me, it's something that I really strive for. I really look at these guys and I'm like, I want to be like them. And these girls that are wonderful with a camera, I'm like, I wish I could do that kind of stuff. And it makes me want to go out and do it. I'm not intimidated by people that are better than me. In fact, I love it. When I played golf in college, I was one of the better players in the conference. I was the best player on my team for years. And I loved playing with the best players. I always wanted to play against the best players because That's where the competition's at. I don't care if I beat somebody who sucks by 8 shots. I wanted to beat somebody who's really good by 1 shot. And what I've found is that's how I just operate in life. I don't want to bring down other people and have them fail. That way I succeed. I want them to play their best, and I want me to play my best, and I want my best to be better. And if it's not better, it's okay, because you can always get better. You can always strive for more. That's what I found with golf. That's what I found with pretty much anything in my life. There's always better. I get that. I'll never be the best, but I want to strive and set goals that I can actually achieve. And when I'm consuming content that's mind-numbing, it's talking about the president, it's negative about the president, positive about the president, negative about these people, positive about these people, whatever it is, it's never good. Everything you're consuming online, for the most part, that everybody else is consuming, is not an overwhelming positive experience. So I think that being mindful about what you watch, how much of it you watch, when you're watching it, are you watching right before bed? Should you be watching something so negative before bed? Probably not. So really just be mindful of the content you consume, because I've done this with so many things and I'm not really that active on social media. I tweet probably like 3 or 4 times a week, but I've noticed that when I'm on Twitter, I just am upset. I get so sad. I like lose faith in humanity, and I know that that's unfair because there are so many wonderful people out there, but the ones that speak the loudest on Twitter are really upsetting. So what I'll say is just be mindful of the content you're consuming. That's what I've learned. I like learning through my own failures. I failed these last 72 days, I would say. I put on weight. I haven't been making videos. I haven't been doing the things I like to do, but I'm fine with it because it happened. And I know that I can always change it. I read a quote one time when it said, "No one chooses where they start, but they choose where they end." And I think that that's a wonderful phrase that everybody can embody. No matter what your upbringing is, whether you have one parent, no parents, 6 parents, whatever it may be, where you start is not your decision, but the choices you make throughout your entire life and where you finish up, that's on you. When you get to the finish line at the end of a race, it's nobody's fault but your own that you came in last. And it's nobody's fault but your own that you came in first. So you can take a lot of pride in that. So I would say that that's something that I've really been focusing on these last couple weeks, which is why I'm so excited to make videos again, because I rekindled the fire that I had and that I know is in there. But sometimes it just gets drowned out by negativity and bad choices. So thank you guys for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one. And there'll be a lot more coming because I got the fire, baby. I got the fire in my belly. In my belly. That's a terrible joke. I don't know. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks again for watching. I'm Scott. And this is Scott's channel. All right, peace out.